Welcome back to the channel, guys. Today we are in Taiwan and we're going to be taking a high-speed bullet train from Taipei to Kaohsiung. We've just arrived at the station here. And we have our tickets.
We bought these from 7-Eleven, just so you guys know. We just went up to the counter because it was really hard to use the machine in English. And she helped us go right through the steps, so...
Make sure you know exactly like what station and stuff you're going to and you have all the details, because her English, she didn't speak it that well. And when she was asking the question, she was going very fast. So luckily Chase is really good with that. But I would just say if you buy them at 7-Eleven, make sure, because they were what, 100 and...
It was 1,500 Taiwanese dollars per person.
Yeah, so they're up there. So just make sure your details are correct. Because once you confirm those tickets, and she's doing it all for you on a screen in like 2 minutes.
Yeah.
You need to know that those are correct.
That's a good advice.
Yeah.
All right. So our train takes off at around 11:30 today. So we just really have to mosey around and see where we are.
Yeah, figure it out. It's 10:55 right now.
Okay.
And we just walked from the Hilton Hotel, so it was super close.
Where are we going for that train? Right there. Okay, thank you very much.
So this nice guy just let us know that we just scan our code here. I can get on the elevator.
Yeah, you just have to scan your things. We're going southbound.
B2 is the platform.
Thank you.
B2, okay.
So we're going to be car number 3. We're train number 125. So let's see if we get in the right car this time.
Yeah, Chase is famous for getting us in the wrong little cabin cars. We've done that, twice now? So our train is not here yet, so we're just waiting. And I have to say, people in Taiwan have been unbelievably friendly. Whenever they see us standing there with our phones or looking like we're confused, they'll come up to us and ask us if we need help. So that is something that has been really, really nice while we've been here.
I agree.
We have a sneak peek of what our train will look like.
We have to say. And then all the boards here keep you informed of like if it's on schedule, if it's going to be delayed.
The trains are just like too convenient. I'll say that time and again, they're just so convenient. It has arrived.
I haven't seen some time. Here we go. I wonder how fast we're zipping on this one today.
I think 300 kilometers.
It seems to be the going speed.
Yeah. Don't put your back out.
It seems like
really sweet. Oh, nice. Yeah, you can go right there. Perfect. Yeah, this is how Chase put his back out last time. He was grabbing my luggage from up here. So we're not playing with that today because he's still in recovery.
Wow, we got the 2-seater today, guys. How did we luck out with this?
There's 3 seats on this side.
We were on the 3-seater on one of our trains.
Oh, okay.
So cool.
There's so much legroom. Holy, no shortage of that.
I'll put these this way.
And we are going the right direction. The seats are definitely
straight up, but you can recline.
Yeah. Where's the recliner?
Over there. Just like that.
I'm gonna have to
A little bit.
It's a little bit more firm.
Hey, same joke. For departure, you gotta put it up. Table tray stowed.
You know what, that's actually, I almost felt like that. I was like, well, I can't yet, but I'm like, wait, I can do literally whatever.
The leg room is absolute insanity. It's excessive.
It's
maybe,
so nice.
Maybe, yeah, show
I could stick
bit.
My stuff under there, but I'm being lazy right now.
Wow. And then this can hold up to, it says 10 kilograms. Huge weight.
Yeah. So it's really cool that you're in a train, but it feels like you're in an airplane because it has everything that you would have on an airplane, except for the leg room, because an airplane would not have that.
Yeah, this is insane.
I feel like it's getting worse and worse in airplanes.
I'm almost going to say maybe we are in first class. Who knows? This is looking luxurious.
Chase did not book first class tickets. Have your little blind there. Very nice.
And the hooks.
And I think that we're going this way, right? Like they wouldn't.
I don't know.
You never know. I'm pretty sure we're going. I don't think we're going backwards, so that's nice.
I don't see charger plugs though. We'll have to investigate.
I don't see them either.
Maybe they're under the seats.
The train's not that long though. I think it's what, like an hour and 45 minutes?
Yeah, something like that.
So, yeah, just make sure to charge your... Oh!
Yes!
We're going this way! Wicked!
Wow, that was like a 3 minute stopover, so...
That was fast.
You gotta be ready.
Yeah.
You gotta be ready.
Wow, that's cool. Every time we get these trains, it's like Russian roulette. We're like, okay, are we going backwards or forwards? But the train came the right way, so I assumed we'd be going this way.
So looking on the little tray table here, you can go see the train master at car 6. Power sockets are in car 4 and 12. Got some vending machines. We would have to go a couple cars to get those. Breastfeeding room and toilets every second car.
It's nice you don't have to get up to know that.
No, that's really, really cool.
It's just right on your tray table.
So maybe we'll head to vending machine car number 5. Because on the way, we can check out the power sockets in number 4.
And hit the washer.
And hit the washer, which would all be that way. So heading to our destination, I think we only have 2 stops before ours. So it's very, very direct, and we're already hitting one. So, wowee.
What was the all stop one?
Well, there's different trains.
Is it like a cheaper ticket, maybe?
Probably, and it takes more. Like, some of them take like 4 hours, some take 6 hours, but they stop at a lot more places.
Around 40 minutes, maybe.
Yeah, this one zips right down south, for sure.
That's one thing I love about the trains, for sure, is the scenery you get to see, and also just, like, the fast time. Like, I'm pro fast trains. I'm pro bullet trains.
Yeah, it's very, very convenient here in Taiwan. It was very convenient in South Korea. And I'm just guessing Japan's probably going to be very convenient as well.
I was looking up on the internet of why places like the US and Canada doesn't have bullet trains. And Canada, one of the reasons was because we're too spread apart. We don't have enough. We're not densely populated.
Our small town's like, what, 100,000 people up in the north?
Yeah, so it just wouldn't make sense. And then to like the rocky, mountainous regions.
Let's just talk about snow too. All of a sudden there's like...
It's like out of commission that's true as well.
Just not a very good terrain.
That wasn't a reason, but that's a great add to, yeah.
I don't know if I'd be wanting to ride a train all the way up to Prince George.
Yeah, they'd be paying people to remove the snow off the track, basically. It's like minus 40.
Something really cool just came by. I saw a lady and she's carrying a little like bag looking thing. And she's coming around to collect garbage to keep the train clean. I saw her little bag had Taiwan high-speed rail, so I'm like, oh, she must work. And then she's going around to people and like...
It's only been here for like 10 minutes, but maybe people have already been on here.
Yeah, I don't know.
Okay.
Keeping it spotless in here, yeah, that's super cool.
Yeah, because there was people on here when we got on here, so that's probably why.
Yeah.
Ooh. Just coming up on a big city. I wonder if it's Taichung.
Let's look. See if our super fast internet works.
Yeah, it's been a little hit and miss.
It's only because of the earthquake, guys. I'm sure you would have a better time.
Yeah, that's what we heard. The guy who sold us our SIM card is like, do you want this? Because there was an earthquake and it might not work yet. This is Taichung.
Cool.
Taichung. Oh, there. Taichung.
Perfect timing.
It's beautiful. After this stop, we're gonna go check out the vending machine and washroom.
It has it so spelt out. We've shown this, but like, look, we walk this way behind us, we get the washroom, we look at the power socket, and then right here is the vending machine. We know exactly what to do.
Exactly.
Oh, that's beautiful.
All right, and we're off. It's time to do the journey. Let's go check it out, guys. We are the next stop after this. Okay, so we have trash bins, washrooms right here, and women only.
Occupied.
Oh, they're all occupied? We'll check them on the way out. So right here should be power sockets.
Oh, this is for your charging station.
Really?
So you can charge your phone or whatever in there.
Okay. Very interesting charging station, but at least they have one if you're in an emergency.
The train's not that long, so again, it almost
makes you feel like you're in prison or something if you need to charge your phone.
It's claustrophobic a little bit.
All right, you're locked in. Well, this is hilarious. Heading to the vending machine, we see someone coming with snacks. Thank you. Okay.
I just want to take a peek at what she has.
Yeah.
We're just looking.
Okay.
Okay. She's confused, I think.
Yeah. Well, was this where the vending machine was? I don't know. Maybe that's our vending machine.
I don't know. Is that what that is?
I guess. I don't know. Let's do one more train just to look. We have found the vending machine, but there ain't much going on.
Not really. They just have drinks and kind of... Not great ones at that.
I'm surprised we jumped the gun just to, like, you know, the lady with the little cart there.
I know. I wonder if we can make it our way back to our seat and just get
something. Here, we gotta show this. But yeah, get there before she's back.
Oh, that's a girl.
Yeah, there's the men's washroom.
It's not for me.
And then a woman's washroom. So I guess guys can't do number two on here.
can they do it over there, maybe?
No.
Oh, man and woman.
Ah, there it is.
And just so you guys know, this only takes coins. And that washroom actually really, really nice. It had soap, it had toilet paper, it was clean, and it even had a really intense hand dryer, so that's really cool. But we're gonna go see if we can catch that lady. Might be too late now. See what she has on her cart. Have we missed her?
Just missed you.
I didn't go chase her down.
Maybe she'll come back. She'll come back. She has to come back, doesn't she? Or is she just going to reside at the other end?
It's very easy.
Well,
I've never been on this train.
We will let you guys know if she comes back from there. Because I think, like I was saying, the train masters stay at number 6. So maybe she'll head back to the train master.
I see someone's dude hanging there. I'm like,
oh, cool. Oh my goodness. That is breathtaking.
Wow.
Oh, how much of Taiwan is covered in rainforest, Charles?
Oh, 58%.
Thanks, John and Linda.
Thanks to our friend John.
There's a brochure. I see a lady who has a brochure. We're ill prepared here, y'all.
Oh, gosh. Oh, no. We'll wing it.
We'll do it. I'm slightly preparing right now.
You really just have to look at something that you might like and be like, that one.
Man, we could get a little miniature-sized bullet train.
I don't know what you're talking about, as I can't see.
It has a little orange stripe and everything. Yeah. Oh, there's also those chocolate teddy bear things from Thailand.
We love those.
I think I see a milk tea.
Ooh.
Oh boy.
I could go for a milk tea. I'm still pretty full from breakfast.
My goodness. 100 should be enough, right?
I don't know, it depends what train. The China one? No. Korea one, yes. Taiwan one, not sure. She's like, is that like a panini press? Like, what is going on? Oh, maybe it's a money box.
Yeah, probably.
Wow. Absolutely stunning, you guys. You will not catch me anywhere without this blanket. Or any type of blanket. I always travel with a blanket. Lots of stuff. Just as like I'm not hungry, I'm like, oh, I wonder if they have pineapple bread.
I know, right?
You know, milk tea.
Milk tea?
Yeah.
Let's see what we get.
Want any of these ones?
This one.
$35?
$35?
Nice.
Velvet milk tea. Very exciting.
Thank you.
Alright guys, let's try a velvet milk tea. And it's nice and cold.
I'm assuming you could smell it. She probably had hot beverages in her little heater containers.
Velvety, sweet milk tea. It says 50% something. Maybe 50% milk. I will say, nice size for $35. Not too shabby.
Okay. Try.
For a train snack, you know?
Mm.
I know, right?
Really good. Mm-hmm. It's like perfect sweetness, perfect milkiness.
I know.
The only thing that would make this better
is boba or jellies or anything.
Boba. Tapioca pearls, so good. Mm. It actually is a really big size.
I know.
That's really nice.
bang for buck.
Yeah.
Two thumbs up.
Yeah, so I'm assuming the other snacks and food probably aren't too much either. That's great.
I have found it. The push train. It would only been 100 actually. And you can get a pencil case as well.
Only 100 for a little train gadget?
Hey, now if you had children or something and they wanted something. Or if you are collecting all of the high-speed train memorabilia? Oh, that's a tongue twister.
That's actually quite high for food.
Okay, 110.
It's a little higher, but maybe you get a big portion.
Not the worst, you know?
Honestly, I don't even know the portion. I'm probably just talking out my ass.
It's probably only like $3 or so.
Oh, okay, that's not bad. See, you know what's so funny is people, sometimes they'll leave comments and they're like, you guys are only bargaining for this much and you're doing this. And I'm like, you guys, half the time I don't even know the conversion. I'm just like,
I deal with the money.
I'm not very good at it. So sometimes I'll think that I'm like, it's a drastic amount or like I was saying there, I just looked and I'm like, oh, that's expensive. And Chase is like, $3. I'm like, oh, that's not bad at all. Like sometimes people should just not take what I say always seriously because...
No, they're fair prices in here.
All right, we're just driving to the station and I honestly can't even believe how fast that was. It felt like we just got on and then got off.
I couldn't even watch a whole YouTube video with all the tunnels that you hit. Like I was watching a 40-minute YouTube video with doing the vending machine and everything. So quick.
And we were in Taipei, which is like up here. And then now we're in Kaohsiung, which is like at the other end of Taiwan. So.
Where's the elevator? Where's the escalator?
We're going this way.
Yeah, let's go check.
Yeah.
There.
It's probably on the other side.
Might be somewhere.
Yeah. Escalator over here.
Yeah, okay.
And now we're just gonna figure out how to get to our hotel because we're not sure if we're gonna have to take another train or a bus. But we are in Kaohsiung.
Now I'm just hoping we get some darn service to move to the next step here.
Oh no.
What about your phone?
Ooh, it's probably not gonna be much better.
I saw you opened up your map better than mine. Come on, one of them. Yours is open. I don't know. Mine's malfunctioning right now. We'll try Shelby's.
And they're both Apples, so that's interesting. Oh, is mine doing it weird now too? Uh-oh.
Well, let's see what happens. Directions.
Oh boy.
Oh yeah, baby. Back in action. So cell service is not working right now, but they have free Wi-Fi. And it didn't require a number, and we're gonna take a red line. 5 minutes to walk there, and 7 minutes to our hotel after that.
Oh,
so not too shabby, about 12 to 13 minutes of walking.
So get Wi-Fi at the airport. You know what? This is all your fault.
It is my fault.
Because every time we take off, he says depart and land, and it makes me think of an airport.
So we both downloaded offline maps, we're able to. Get to our hotel.
Yeah, so if it doesn't work for you, just get on the free Wi-Fi and download your offline maps. Obviously.
And hopefully the same cards will work once we leave here.
I hope so. Hopefully it's just like an area it's not working, because that would suck.
Awesome, let's go.
So we're making our way towards the red line, and we are actually just exiting the building, down another escalator.
We get to pull out our cute little easy cards.
Yeah, my little pink one. Chase's butt. Or peach, we don't know. I say this every time, but my biggest fear is one of those things is just gonna close on my hips. So there's the red line.
I'll take your card. We'll probably head down the escalator. It always does this to us.
What a tease. Just missed it. How often does it come? It's probably pretty often though.
Probably 5 minutes.
Real Canadian superstore.
Yeah, it says 6 minutes on the sign.
Okay, yeah. That's the nice thing about these trains is if you just miss it, another one comes very soon.
Oh, yeah. And I think we're only 15 minutes on this, and then, yeah, whatever that walk was, 5-7 minutes, and
yeah. We'll be at the Rio Hotel. Okay. Super quick travel day. So easy. Whenever we take these high-speed trains, I'm like, did we even travel?
I know, right? And this thing is still kicking. We're just at half level.
It's a big old drink. We've made it on the train. And just to let you know, our Wi-Fi, our data, has started working. So I think it was just...
I don't know what was going on. It was just in that train station.
Yeah, so we are all good. And we'll see you guys at the other end.
You can get books. I'm assuming it has something to do with that, but I don't think there's any English, so I have no idea. That's pretty cool, though.
Yeah, we got off at the Central Park Station.
Yeah, and we have about a 5-minute walk to our hotel, I believe.
7 minutes.
7 minutes.
I know. Extra 2 minutes. And we're going out exit 3 here.
All right, we have arrived, and I hope that we can check in because we are here an hour early.
1:50.
Yeah, so hopefully our room is ready. That would be really cool. And here we go. Push. Oh, this is
that's a big door.
It's a grand door. Hello, ni hao.
Drinks and coffee.
Oh, really cool.
Enjoy cookies and candies.
Okay, nice. Yeah. Is this the like afternoon tea or no?
Afternoon tea. Will
oh, it's
be...
that different.
Yeah.
Okay,
different.
Okay.
Yeah.
This is just like a snack cookie bar.
Yes.
Oh, cool.
They are available for 20 hours.
Okay, perfect. Sounds great.
Yes.
Awesome.
Here is your our restroom.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. You can stay here.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. So yeah, check-in time is 3. Our room is not ready. So look at this lobby.
It's kind of cool how you have to like come up and they have like a quiet lobby kind of in a way.
Yeah. So that was just like a little baby, you know, walk-in lobby, but this is like the actual lobby and it's like stunning in here, so we'll just chill here for an hour until
by the window
we check in,
or maybe over here.
That looks more comfy with the backrest.
So look at this cool thing. It looks like you got MacBooks that you can use, and this keyboard. Look at this. Oh my goodness. Don't know if this is for us. It kind of looks like it. If you just need to do a few things, surf the internet. Super cool.
Well, hello. Welcome to our room. Come on in.
One second. Oh my goodness.
I literally thought that was going to make like a doorbell sound. Literally, not going to lie, that threw me off.
It's like a little bird sound.
It's so cute. But this is our room for the next couple of nights. And right away, we have the big king size bed. And this hotel is kind of known to be like artsy, which I didn't realize. Every floor has like a different theme. What is our theme?
Ink drop, as you can slightly tell.
So all the rooms like will have some kind of like ink drop theme, which is really, really nice. And you have like this rolled blanket, which is just like such a nice touch.
Yeah.
So let me just, I mean, the bed's right here, right? So let me just, oh.
Wow.
Can you tell how soft that is? Bouncy and soft and squishy. Oh my gosh. It's like calling my name right now. That's so nice. But then we have this beautiful view, and there's palm trees. Have we even seen palm trees here yet?
I don't think so.
I don't think so. It's just a beautiful view of the city. And something super cool is when we actually checked in, we got these little eye masks.
There's 3 options.
So you could pick from options, and there, I think there was like soap, lotion, eye mask, and I like have soap and lotion, so I was like, let's do the eye mask. And also, this is, it ties into this. So in the fridge, you have this, which is basically
cucumbers, guys.
And you have water that says 4 masks. So then the girl, when she was like just showing us our room, said that you put these little masks. Look at this cutie little thing. You put the water, you put the cucumber in here, let it soak for an hour, the water, and then you put the mask in here with the water, and then put it on your face.
Mm-hmm.
So tonight, it's gonna be like ultimate relaxation, spa vibes. We're gonna put on our little robes.
Put on the robes, and by the way, these very nice plush slippers over there, and everything in these drawers.
It's free.
It's absolutely free. Those pops you saw.
Got like little snacks. And there's a scale down there. We're not going to use it, but
yoga mat
it's
too.
It's kind of unique because how you like turn it on, look at this. It charges it.
It uses no batteries, guys.
I will not be using that, but it's nice. It's a nice little additive, I suppose. But then kettle, of course, you have your kettle and drip coffee as well.
Yes.
Which is really nice. And then the best part. In my opinion, the best part is the bathtub. Look at this gorgeous girl. She looks, actually looks like you might fit in there too.
Yep.
Sometimes Chase doesn't fit that well, but this one actually looks huge.
And they have a work desk and...
Bath salts. Yes.
You want to know something else that's really unique? Look at this, guys. It's a floating toilet.
It's very modern.
Yeah.
I've never seen a toilet like this. So that's super cool. You like flush it up here.
Yeah.
And then you have this for Chase, which is deodorizer.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know what's funny? Chase, you call this a work desk. You know what this is actually for?
What?
Books and relaxation things, not working.
Well, I guess my life is based upon editing.
And literally, you know, it's a work desk in the bathroom. I'm like, no, not really. It's for like
chilling. Well, it could be snacks and tea
drinks.
And stuff. Yeah.
It's like this work desk. Oh my gosh. But then you come over here and there's a big shower. You have shampoo and shower gel. And then all your toiletries in here.
Oh man. Oh man.
And you have like a little deck too.
Yes.
To go out and go on the deck. You know what I find? Not many hotels we've had so far have a little luggage thing.
Mm-hmm.
This is always in Canada. You will always usually find
these. Yeah.
But we have not seen that anywhere in Asia, I don't think.
That's interesting to see, yeah.
Yeah. But also, they have a takeout menu from the Lookout Bistro and Bar, and it's basically on the top, very top floor of this hotel. And I was looking at their menu because other people that aren't from the hotel come here and go to it because the food looks incredible. So we might honestly just be little hotel bums today and relax and go for dinner.
I believe breakfast is in the same area, right?
Breakfast is in the same area.
Yeah.
Well. Yeah. So, yeah, that big TV, bed, masks. Do you feel my vibes here?
Oh man.
So.
Relaxation.
I'm very excited. We are gonna go check out the little
afternoon. It's in 4 minutes.
Oh shoot, we're early. We're terrible. I'm roaring to go. It's such a beautiful day out today.
Yes.
Wow. Okay, we'll wait our 4 minutes. Sit down like a little good girl. I'm sure you could just go over there right now, though.
I'm sure, yeah.
Okay, let's just go. It's probably fine. Yes, this is the Times Gourmet Dessert and Snack Bar.
Boom, boom, and boom, boom.
Free of charge during your stay. Oh my gosh. I'm so excited. So you can do, ice cream machine. Definitely gonna have to try that. Oh, wow. You can have like chicken and noodles and stuff?
A snack bar?
Oh, cute.
This is wild. Look,
yummy.
This looks real good.
So like one of everything or?
I think so.
Oh my gosh.
So.
Okay, build us a plate. Well, we're probably gonna need 2 plates. So this is what we got. We got some various little snacks and cakes and tarts. And then look at the cutie little noodle cups.
Yeah.
And then some vegetables and then pickled plum tomatoes.
Yeah, this is a salted chicken of some sort.
Yeah, so then we also got, I think this is just like a fruit juice. And some kind of like sparkling water. And then Chase, of course, got a coffee.
Yes, an espresso.
Mm. Very chill and refreshing. And then we also got something in here.
This is a red bean.
Oh, you should crack into that.
Yes. It is a famous dessert from this town.
Oh, that's cool.
Ooh. It's like Christmas. So, we got 2 of them in here.
Oh, nice.
I'll pull out one. All right, good. Look at that.
Oh, it looks good.
It's nice and like it almost has a custardy flavor.
Let's try.
It's nice and sweet.
Oh, it's warm a little bit.
Yeah. It has a really nice sweetness. I can get down with that.
And you said that was bean?
It is bean, yes.
It doesn't taste like bean at all. Tastes like a pancake with a custard.
But yeah, looking at it, I thought it was red bean, but it's more of a white bean.
But it's not beany at all, it's delicious.
They've done a very good job there.
So good.
And we have 2 of them in there.
This is really intriguing me. Oh my goodness, Chase.
What is that?
Whoa. So good.
You know I'm gonna be down here again tomorrow. Maybe even tonight.
I want to eat this whole thing. It's like a sesame buttery flaky.
Oh, we're gonna get more of those. Oh, that's good. Oh, that's good.
Mmm. Nice cake. Wow. I really want to try those noodles.
Noodles?
Mm-hmm.
Well then, I'll make you wait a little longer while I try the noodles then. I don't want to make a mess. Oh, goodness.
One bite noodle cups. I love it.
Well, it's a snack bar. It's a very unique flavor. It's like, I'm almost getting like, it's either a herb or like a pickled
taste. It almost looks like lemongrass.
And then it's spicy noodles. Here, I'll give you your own shot glass so you get the whole. They also, I don't know if that's like a saffron or something, but some sort of herb there that's very unique.
Looks like it looks like chili threads. When I used to work at the Rockford, that's a restaurant I worked at.
That's probably what it is, because saffron's really expensive.
They're, yeah, and saffron isn't like
India based.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do this over. Should I just go with breath?
Yeah.
You guys.
It's getting a little messy over there.
You can't take me anywhere.
It's really good.
Oh my gosh.
It's really good.
The quality
is
pretty mind-blowing right now.
Oh, you're getting that one fungus. Look at this funky fungus there, guys. I also picked up this one right here. They have some really unique looking mushrooms.
Oh my goodness, that's like five spice.
The salty chicken dish.
I have no words. The quality, okay, plum tomato.
Yeah.
The quality, 10 out of 10.
Well, that's cool. It's like a candy tomato. Oh man.
I have to not eat too much because we're gonna go for dinner tonight, so can't eat too much.
That is so hard not to.
We have to go with ice cream though.
Yeah. So the little ice cream machine, it's special today, is mango.
Yeah, so they have different flavors. I used it all by myself.
Oh my goodness. Oh. That mango flavor. We actually had to go back for some of these sesame buns. Everything over there is so freaking good. So quiet in here, or I'd be even more excited, guys. I don't want to disturb the peace.
It's really peaceful in here, so we're like trying to be quiet. We're like, if you know us, just know we're in heaven right now.
Yep.
Okay guys, it's time for some dinner and we're doing a voiceover because they are playing some lovely music and we do not want to get copyright. We came at the perfect time for sunset and ordered some cocktails while we decided on some dinner. First up was this deep fried chicken wing stuffed with shrimp meat, which was super unique. They had an insane crunch and were so juicy and literally paired perfectly with the sweet and tangy sauce. Next up were these flaky, buttery scallion cakes stuffed with tender, flavorful beef tongue, chimichurri, and cheese. The herbs and the tomatoes on top added such a nice freshness. This dish was honestly a 10 out of 10. It was so good. Our first main course was a lamb rump sitting on a bed of rosemary. It cut like butter and came with a mint sauce, which added a nice contrast. The smokiness took me by surprise. If you like smoked meat, then this dish is for you. Next, I had to try the potato gnocchi with peas. Soft, pillowy, delicious. Cocktails have arrived. Chase went with the espresso martini and I went with this like Earl Grey refreshing citrus cocktail. Both drinks were strong and really, really tasty. The next dish we got was a seafood risotto. Wow, wow, wow. This had so much umami and was so cheesy. If you guys didn't catch it, this restaurant is called the Lookout Bistro and Bar. Our meal was great, the staff was amazing, and we are absolutely stuffed. Now we're gonna go right on up to our hotel room and do nothing for the rest of the night. And we'll see you in the morning for breakfast. Okay guys, it is the next morning. We are heading up to breakfast. I'm gonna smuggle in some Yakults.
They're gonna be like, this is a fine establishment. Fine,
I don't know. Yeah, they're gonna be like, get those out of here. I don't know why, but I love drinking these on an empty stomach because I just feel like
Maybe the probiotics.
Maybe the probiotics. Yeah. Maybe they'll like wiggle their way to my stomach and be better for my gut health. I don't know. That's probably totally wrong. But let me know if you know if that's a thing. I have no idea.
They're trying to make their way to their intestines. So. Intestine.
Oh, the intestines. Intestines are in the stomach. Guts. Same thing.
They have to make it past the stomach.
Guts are intestines.
The whole time.
If you want to get technical, I said guts.
All right.
My guts. Wow. This is so cool.
Mm-hmm.
Ink. Mm-hmm. Ink art. What was it called? Ink?
Drop ink art.
Drop ink or something?
You're testing my memory now.
Yeah. Keeping you on your toes.
It was just yesterday. How could I forget?
Sorry, this table is not covered.
Oh, we can do this one. Yeah, sure. Sure. Yeah. Yeah, this is fine.
Okay. Awesome. And today this Asian style is Chinese mini porridge.
Okay.
It's come with 8 dishes, side dishes.
Okay.
And other like yesterday.
Oh, okay, perfect. And so there's Benedict. What's the classic house breakfast? What is in there?
It includes this ABC.
Oh, okay. Okay, got you.
ABC is...
You picked that one of those.
Okay, cool. Okay, thank you. So this looks good.
Mm-hmm.
Blade steak with sous vide eggs. Seafood.
Well, I heard blade steak. Sign me up for one of those.
Yeah, I'm down for the blade steak too. Obviously, we're probably going to be sharing. I thought the Asian style breakfast sounded good too.
It's a porridge?
Meaty porridge?
I don't know.
You said the Asian style breakfast is a meaty porridge?
Meaty porridge.
Is it like a pork?
Pork? No. Kanji.
Yeah.
Kanji. Okay, yeah. Just plain. Okay, yes. Okay.
A meaty is... you know meaty?
Millet. Oh yeah. Okay. Yeah.
It's another rice.
Yeah, oh. Okay. Perfect. Okay. Perfect.
We have picture like this.
Oh.
Oh yeah.
Porridge.
Oh.
And,
okay.
Dishes.
Okay. Perfect.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Oh, that's okay. Nice. He came and showed us. I think we're gonna go with the blade steak. And the seafood scrambled eggs.
How often do you get a seafood scramble?
That's yeah, cool. That sounds really good.
Now you just have to pick your poison here.
Ooh, I think I'm gonna get a. I think I'm gonna get a green tea.
Okay.
Yep. I think I'm gonna get a iced green tea. To have my yakults. I'm not being very inconspicuous, am I?
And iced.
I already downed mine. She gone.
We just got salad, honey cake, and some yogurt.
We just heard, if you eat this, you can get another one. And another one, probably.
I should just be like, can I get another salad, please?
No, you must have the honey cake and the yogurt, too.
I'll let you eat that all first, then I'll get another salad. I'm vibing with this salad. I have like a Caesar dressing and there's fresh guava. Oh,
okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
From House of Honey Cake and the yogurt.
This? It's really refreshing. Look at this cute little honey cake. It has the lookout on.
Oh my god, I didn't even notice that. That's awesome. That's so cute they stamped it.
We got our drinks. I almost forgot what I got. It was a honey something.
Honey lemonade, I think.
Oh, so nice. I wonder if, because I got a nice drink, yours came in like a cup, so they differentiated.
Or oh, maybe.
What the difference is there, but.
You know what I love doing? Making a mess, but I love dipping my lettuce in dressing. Then you get more on it. So this is a seafood with scrambled eggs. It looks like it comes with mushrooms and a tomato and cabbage, and then another salad, and this flaky looking croissant and some kind of syrup.
Oh my. Would you look at that?
Ooh.
Some more croissants.
That blade steak looks so good.
Wow.
Super, super tender. And it looks like you get a poached egg, some mushrooms, broccoli, tomato. Oh, I'm really distracted by how delicious that blade steak is.
Yum. Can't wait to try it.
So I just took my first bite of croissant. And my goodness, guys, this syrup is one of the best syrups I've ever had in my life. It's like...
And we're Canadian. We have Canadian maple syrup.
It has like a maple syrup taste, but then it like almost tastes like when you were baking and you like caramelize.
Or he like put like, oh, there's like bourbon or something
in it. I don't know. Oh my goodness.
like flakiest croissants. So delish.
I'm so happy these come with almost all of the meals, I guess. Like, you got it, I got it. They're handing out these delicious croissants to everybody.
We are back at the hotel room now, nice and full. That was so good. We hope you enjoyed this video. We've been loving taking the trains. Now we're gonna go out and explore, so make sure to stay tuned for the following videos, and we'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!